Hey, everybody, it's episode 11. I hope you're not too warm, not too hot, because this is still Valley. It's got nothing to do with the weather. There's no water shortages. There's no looters. There's no radio announcers breaking down. That last episode had everything. Rooftops, ninjas, paintings that could predict the future. That wasn't part of it. Anyway, this one is still Valley, and I have no idea what it's going to be about, so let's just get into it.
Your next stop, the Twilight Zone. The time is 1863. Ooh. The event is a mass bloodletting known as the Civil War.
What is it?
There's this road, see, with loads of people walking down it. I see Abraham Lincoln. Ooh. Careful, dude.
You figured this would fire if you was to press the trigger?
Yeah.
Derek. You figure you'll shape up by the end of the war? I can't help
it. It's not like that, you know? I'm just a coward, is all.
It used to be like it was some kind of game we was playing like kids.
Yeah.
But ain't that way anymore,
Pretty. Real people are dying.
I've seen too much of this business.
Why is there just two of them on their own? They had an advanced scout
party?
You
haven't got a nerve in your body, have you, Paradine?
Just as many as you, son. I'm worrying about two scouts on a mission.
Yep, scouts.
A dirty piece of brown paper.
Our orders?
We gotta scout them and report back as soon as they get into that town down there.
Easy, we don't have to shoot anybody. Observe and report. What are we seeing?
Yanks,
probably.
Okay.
That's funny.
Listen, Joe, we're exposing ourselves here. There's no place to stand out in the open.
Reckon I better get down there and take a close look.
Hey, just be careful.
Let's pull out. I don't like it.
It's spooky, you know? It's not what we expected.
Now, what's the point in going down
there? I'm with this guy.
The point is we gotta count their heads, their horses, and their guns. Got enough point for you, Mr. Dolgan?
Damn it.
I only got one big mission left, and that's to stay alive.
Ooh, we got hit.
I'll extend my sympathy so long as your yellow eats at your insides. But when it crawls into my bivouac and tries to climb up on my horse...
Keep your cowardice away from me. Get out of here.
If you hear a shot, you get back to the lieutenant at a fast gallop. And you tell him what happened.
He shouldn't be going down there. There could be Martians and all sorts of things. He just rode in there, you know? He's not trying to hide or anything. He's being quiet, but you don't take your horse with you if you're trying to be sneaky. You can't hide behind that. This guy is the worst hider ever. This is why you need the cowards. They know all the best spots to hide in. Yeah, they'll never spot you there. Okay. Oh shit. What did he see? What are you looking at? You see aliens? Future people? Horses? Time stopped? Time is stopped. Oh, still. Still Valley. They're all still. I push one of them over just to see if they're faking it. Well, time to get the regiment number and get out of there. You know, do your job.
Must be sleeping, or are you dead?
They're sleeping. Standing up.
Plague, maybe. Some kind of sickness. Time.
Some sort of paralysis.
Must be asleep.
Are you on that funeral planet?
Wake up.
Yeah, just start shooting.
Go on.
Could be a hero.
All right, Yanks. Go, my prisoner.
They're just pranking you, dude. That's why the sound suddenly stopped.
Food?
Yeah.
Clothing? You come to the right valley. Nothing around here but hungry Confederates.
Great. Take their stuff and go. If it was me, I'd be afraid they'd start moving at any moment, so I'd just do my job and get out of there.
Just don't understand. Speak, none of you can move.
Yeah, seems that way. This guy is the strongest guy ever, just holding it like this. Taking some of the food?
First meat I've had in a couple of months, you hear?
Mm. Oh, shit. Invisible people. Moving stuff. Maybe you're the one who's frozen and there's other people. Super moving. It's just the wind. This is the wind. It's the first sensible thing he's said all day. Shit. The wind has hands. Just someone who was here when they arrived. They don't have to be a yank.
You better come out now, I'm coming in.
I'm here for your juice and your water, babe. Hey, you're not a babe.
Well, old man.
Do you see all this stuff, old man?
You don't know how close you come to dying just then.
What's going on with them?
When I first seen you coming up the street, I thought you was a yank. You don't know how close you come to dying.
What was he gonna use, Grandpa? That book?
This book. Just use it.
Is it a spell book?
Like I used it on them.
Ooh, he's a magician, he's a warlock.
You think I'm lying?
It's a good reason as anything.
I ain't calling you no liar. Something happened to him.
I can see it with my own eyes.
But his ears were done it.
Can I have it? Ooh, witchcraft. Whatever you say, old-timer.
But I got no time to fiddle around with black magic or any other old men's games.
Games, you call it?
Games? I'll show you games.
Sam's the enemy?
Let me show you.
Name of the Prince of Darkness. And
now listen, old man.
How about it now, Johnny Reb?
Can he hear you?
You're going to have to stand there.
Ooh, that's bad for your back.
Well, I know you can still hear me.
Okay. Where'd you get the book?
I'm a witch man. Like my pappy afore me. And then the Yanks come.
Damn Yanks.
Invaders. Tyrants.
Yep. A whole lot of them.
I'll open the book and I'll read the words. You can see what happened to them.
What else you got in that book of yours? Can we make some money?
Now, you be good and don't give me no argument. Blink your right eye.
Wait. Oh, he can move. He's cheating.
Now, you're conjured here in the name of the Prince of Darkness.
Ooh, Satan.
You can now move and speak.
Okay, old-timer. I'll be taking that witchcraft book of yours.
Hypnotism.
Hypnotism.
What do you think I am, David Blaine?
What I done to them Yanks, I can do to the whole Union Army.
Do it.
So that Bobby Lee could ride in there with three.
You claim it's magic.
I don't claim it.
You seen it.
I seen
with your own eyes.
You seen it.
You could do this to the whole Union Army?
We could win the war.
Good and would. Good and would.
Well, why don't you now?
Why don't you, old man?
I'm going to die. I'm going to die before the sun goes down.
What? Well, if you're in that last episode, you wouldn't die. The sun wouldn't go down.
Well, I ain't going to be around to do what's got to be done. I'm leaving it up to you.
Oh, you give me the book?
I'm choosing you.
Here. This is interesting, because we know what happens in reality.
Don't seem right. There's something. Something unclean. Being in league with the...
Like when he said Lucifer?
The devil. The devil himself. That's who we'll have fighting on our side.
It's an interesting moral question, isn't it? If you think what you're doing is right, but you need the devil to make it happen, do the means outweigh the ends?
You've been gone a long time, Paradine. We give you up.
Witchcraft.
You're a prisoner by this time. Well, out with the man. What'd you see?
More than you'd believe, Lieutenant.
They've heard a sound from that valley all day.
Their advance party's in that town.
They're all right. They're just being very quiet.
Drunk or something, Paradine?
But the reason you didn't hear them is they're all asleep. Put to sleep by magic. Black magic.
Have a look.
You're to take yourself to bed. Make your report to me in the morning.
Okay.
This is my report, Lieutenant. Where's Mallory's troop?
They went up the North Ridge late this morning.
On the way back here, Lieutenant, I opened a book and I...
Oh, he said the words.
Read from a page of it. I conjured up a spell.
They all think they're chickens.
And I turned it in the direction of that ridge.
Report.
I just seen something I can't explain.
Ooh, black magic.
We was walking up that ridge in skirmish line.
What you see?
They was waiting all right. Standing straight and tall, guns to port. Frozen like statues.
Dead.
They were sleeping.
This done
the book. I did it.
Paradine, this is the devil's work.
Yeah, but, you know, he's on our side, so...
It is the devil's work.
Should we use it?
Maybe it's time we call muster on the devil.
Should we use it?
We're losing, Lieutenant. The Confederacy's cracking up into little pieces right in front of our eyes.
I don't know much about Satan, but this cause of ours is dying right in front of us.
Pardine, open up the book and read from it out loud.
Ooh.
Freeze him. Put him into the earth or something.
Is he gonna do it?
Satan, I call upon you, and in so doing, I'll revoke the name of...
God? He can't do it. He can't do it. Lieutenant, do you want to do it?
Go on, Joe, read it.
You read it, coward.
You said yourself it's the only thing we got left.
He's right, Paradine. God help us. That is all we have left.
God isn't going to help you, though.
That's the phrase, ain't it? Damn Yanks.
Yeah.
If I read aloud from this book, it'll be the Confederacy that's damned.
It's that book or it's the end.
Then let it be the end.
On the following morning, Sergeant Paradine and the rest of these men were moved up north to a town called Gettysburg. And this one was fought without the help of the devil.
That was Still Valley. I don't know much about the American Civil War, but I do know that Gettysburg was like... I don't know if you want to call it a turning point in the war, but like a major battle in the war that went for the Union against the Confederates. So yeah, that little reference at the end, little obscure town called Gettysburg. It's kind of funny. And this was a tale about two scouts, two Confederate scouts. One was a coward, one was not. I'm not really sure what the point of the cowardly guy was at the start. I thought he would, thought there'd be some more, maybe it was just to fill time or something, or just to set up the whole scene. And then the guy sneaks into town, riding in on his horse. No, he's not even trying to hide the fact that he's coming in. And then he starts sneaking around, hiding behind like really narrow poles and everything. Until he sees, a whole bunch of them. Those damned Yankees, just everywhere. And then he goes on a bit of a Twilight Zone monologue at them. You know the ones? Where he's like, what? What's going on? Where? Is this just a prank? Whoa. Why can't you speak? You know, that sort of thing. Kind of verbalizing the audience's questions. Without immediately just going to like, hey, has time stopped? Are they breathing? You know, check all the normal things. Maybe I should just get out of here because there's weird witchcraft going on. He doesn't know that yet. Then he meets the man. Ooh. This man, he's got his book. Seventh son of a seventh son of a seventh son of Satan. But he's dying. He's going to die the next day. So he's like, you are the only person I've seen that I trust with this book. You'll use it, won't you? Even though the guy is clearly anti-witchcraft, or at least, you know, skeptical of it. You know, he doesn't seem a natural fit to get the book. And in the end, he wasn't. He rejected it. Threw it on the fire. If we have to reject the Lord, it's not worth it to win the battle. So he made that moral choice. Not the lieutenant guy. Not the coward guy, the middle guy. Throwing the war away. It is an interesting question. If you had the power, would you damn yourself for the cause? Yeah, I think most people wouldn't. I think most people wouldn't. Yeah, there's lots of questions, so you have to think about how much do you really believe in that sort of thing. You know, if you had this book that could do this and win you the war, but you didn't believe in Satan, you know, wouldn't you just use the book anyway? Or maybe it's selfish, you know? You're not willing to give up your soul to save the cause and, you know, something you really believe in, whatever the actual issues are, you know, clearly I don't think anybody thinks the Confederate, well, but let's not get into history, but you know, imagine if the Union had the book, for example. The same questions would be asked. Would you damn yourself, your own soul, in order to save the lives of all the people on your side and to ensure the victory and a prosperous future? You know, isn't it selfish of you to go, oh no, I can, not me. You want to read it? I can't be part of this. Not me. Nope. So that's where the interesting questions in that episode for me come in. Also, is there anything in that spellbook that can make it so that this guy can be a bit more stealthy? That would be helpful. Anyway, they all died later. A few days later. The end. Sorry to spoil the Civil War for you. Next episode is called The Jungle. So we had a still valley. Next time we've got a jungle. It's not going to be still. Not going to be witchcraft. There might be monkeys. See you.